I say this. This generation prepare for wedding, they don't prepare for marriage. If I can promise you, even the counsel you give to them, they don't listen.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. That is why sometimes they come late. You, the teacher counselor, is there. They're supposed to show up 5 o'clock. They come 6:30 and they complain about traffic. When they get visa to go to America, see whether they'll go to airport late. I think God doesn't know who you are. What is the purpose? What is the purpose of marriage? Why are you getting married? Why are you in the marriage? For sex? Correct. It's part of it. Companionship, I need it. I hate to finish preaching and nobody's around me. I don't like it. And if this man of God will be faithful, sometimes you fail for sex after tremendous anointing. No, this is how the things they can tell you. That is why sometimes I have a problem with pastors who do programs and travel alone without their wives. And I'm not surprised in no time there is a rumor that they are committing adultery. There is no time you feel lonely than after a powerful meeting. Somebody must be around you. They don't talk about it. No. All of you that serve pastors, don't get too close to them after they finish preaching. Don't. You can be a major source of temptation. Because when the anointing is lifted temporarily and you come back to your flesh, it demands some things. Your flesh demands some things. I don't understand. You see, Paul said that after the fasting, come back quickly. Because the fasting releases some anointing that if you mess up, you enter temptation, you quash all the fasting. No, you see, for instance, it will be unfair for me to start working with this, my daughter, and think that he operates in the level of faith I operate. He doesn't. So don't be a pastor and think that everybody is at your level. And what I'm doing this week is that I'm coming down because what did I do to get to where I am? What have I been through? If I just pretended like I got there because I am strong, then I am not a good general. I used to threaten with divorce. One day he told me something that woke me up. I said, why is it anytime we are talking, you bring out divorce matter? This is about maybe 8 years ago. How did I wake up? So you see, the fact that somebody is working does not mean the devil has not touched people before. I'm a man of God, I'm anointed, but I've been touching. How did I come out? That's what I want to show you. She never talk about those things. It was not part of it. Me that is anointed, me that I'm making. It's not even that. What is it? I mean, you can go so that I can have my freedom to do my work. And when they go to me, do you think it's a freedom? But most of the men of God let to appear that their marriage is butter and bread. And everything has been fine. No. You think I'm preaching this thing because I'm coming from heaven? You have to go through a mess to have a message. Maybe you are not articulate and extrovert like me to voice it out by just in your head. The dangerous is those who have it in their head but they don't talk. No, I'm tired of living with you. You are saying it in your head. I'm finding a way to just get rid of you. And you start providing the symptoms to let them feel like he's rejected. There's nothing that is so bad like you live with somebody that feels like he doesn't need you. It's a torture. That because this pastor's wife sing, my wife must sing. One day, I used to tell her, I'm going to preach. Sing before I preach. Sing. Am I a choirster? Be a choir. Go to singing school. And I'm telling you, some people preach on me. Fill my cup, Lord. One day, I even told her, there's a music school in America. Let's go there. It is based on lack of knowledge. The fact that the pastor's wife sings that show me he has a good marriage. The fact that a pastor's wife is preaching does not mean they are living in harmony.